Okay, students, so in this lecture we are going to discuss about statistical tests of random number. So by statistical test of random number, I mean that I have to test whether there is a series of random number which is generated, whether they are random or not. Okay, so I have to check whether this series of random numbers is having randomness in it or not. Okay, so the first way is to find the average and standard deviation of that series, okay, of the random number series which you have generated. Okay, now for uniform random numbers, okay, see, suppose that you want to generate uniform random numbers between 0 to 1, okay? So what you mean by this is that it doesn't mean that most of the random numbers are generated after 0.5. You also don't want that most of the random numbers are generated below 0.5. You don't want that most of the random numbers are generated near 0. Okay, you also don't want that most of the random numbers are generated near 1. What you want is that the random numbers, okay, are uniformly generated between 0 and 1. Okay, so for that the probability distribution function P of X should be 1. It should not have any kind of bias. Okay, if you bias this probability distribution function, then it may happen that the random numbers are generated after some points. So P of X is equal to 1 for uniform random numbers. Okay, so this is the thing. Now I have to calculate the average. Okay, so average, so suppose X is the random number, X is the series of random number. Okay, so I have to calculate the value of Xi, okay, which is basically the average. Okay, and I have to calculate the standard deviation. So standard deviation sigma can be written as under root of X square minus X square. Okay, so to calculate this quantities, I will need the value of X and X square. Okay, so instead of calculating this quantities, let us write for any number X to the power k. Okay, this value will be given as 1 by n, which is the total number of random numbers generated. I is equal to 1 to n Xi to the power k into P of Xi. Okay, so this is the value. Now for uniform random numbers, P of Xi should be 1. Okay, P of Xi is equal to 1. So what does it mean that X to the power k is equal to 1 by n . Now if a very large number of random numbers are generated, okay, let us take up the limit for n tends to infinity, then this summation can be converted into integration. Okay, then okay, summation and divide by n can be converted to integration between the limit 0 to 1, because I am trying to generate the random numbers between 0 to 1 x to the power k dx. Okay, here we are dealing about the generation of random number between the number 0 and 1. Okay, so this is the thing. Now if you integrate this, it will be 1 upon k plus 1. Okay, so this is the number. So X to the power k is equal to 1 upon k plus 1 for uniform random numbers and the limit where n tends to infinity. Okay, so this is the formula. Now, what are the quantities which you have to calculate? The quantity first of all x. Okay, so here k is 1, so x will be 1 upon 1 plus 1, so this is 1 by 2. Okay, so average over x will be equal to 1 by 2. Okay, so this is the first thing. Okay, and the other thing which you have to calculate is the standard deviation, which is equal to under root of x square minus x square. Oh, sorry. So this will be equal to under root of, okay, so it is x square, so it is 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4, and this will be equal to, this is 1 by 3 and this is equal to 1 by 4, and this should be equal to 0.2886. okay, so for uniform random numbers, okay, the standard deviation should be 0.2886 and the average should be equal to 1 by 2. Now what do you do? That you are having a series of random number, okay, so for that series of random numbers you try to generate, you try to find out what is the standard deviation coming and you try to find out what is the average value coming. If the average value is near to 1 by 2, okay, and the standard deviation is equal to 0.2886, then you can say that your series of random number which is generated is a random series. Okay, so this is the first test which you can do by measuring the standard deviation and the average. The second test, which is more famous, and it is known as autocorrelation function. Okay, you must be understanding what is autocorrelation function in your next semester during StatMech course. Okay, autocorrelation function. Okay, which basically measures the degree of correlation. Okay, of correlation. Okay, so what will happen that if there is a 4, okay, and the next number is also 4, then the degree of correlation is very high since both are the same number. Okay, so if I am writing 5, then what is the degree of correlation? So basically it is measuring the degree of correlation with the previous number, okay, for the next number. So there is a very standard formula for autocorrelation function, which is given as C of k equal to x of I plus k xk, sorry, xi minus xi square divided by xi square minus xi square. Okay, so this is how this thing is written. Okay, so this is the how this autocorrelation function is defined. Here these are the same simple things, you know how to calculate them. The only difficult thing is xi plus k into xi. So the formula for this is 1 upon n minus k divided by I equal to 1 to n minus k xi into x of I plus k. Okay, so this is the value of this function. So what you have to do is you have to measure the correlation function at each interval. So suppose that for k is equal to 0, okay, now if k is equal to 0, then it basically means that this and this number are same, because xi into xi, so this numbers if are same, then you can see that ck will come out to be xi square minus xi square divided by xi square minus xi square. Okay, so you can see that this both numerator and denominator can be cancelled, and this value is equal to 1. Okay, so this is the maximum value of correlation which can be found, okay, for k is equal to 0. Okay, so you can see that ck is 0, ck is equal to 1, okay, for correlation, highest correlation, okay, and for uncorrelated numbers ck will be equal to 0, okay, or ck tends to 0. Okay, so what you do is you plot a graph of, so with the series of random numbers which you have got, you try to plot a graph of ck versus k. Okay, so for k is equal to 0, definitely you will get a ck is equal to 1, okay, and after that for truly random numbers what will happen, that it will directly go to 0 and fluctuate around this, okay. So if you are getting this kind of graph, then your numbers are truly random, okay, and if the fluctuations are very large, okay, suppose that you are getting this kind of graph, okay, then there is a very high degree of correlation between your numbers, and those numbers are not random. So this is how you can measure the degree of correlation between two numbers, okay, and the other way is to do the average value, is to find the average value in the standard deviation of that formula, okay.